And now, Sportsline with Jeff Landers.
Some call it a homecoming, some call it unfinished business. Whatever it is, LeBron James has decided to go back to Cleveland. Today, James announced his decision to return to the Cavaliers after he opted out of his contract with Miami just a few weeks ago. James led the Heat to four straight NBA Finals, winning two championships. ESPN.com is reporting the deal is worth $88 million over 4 years, which is the maximum contract the 11-year veteran could earn. Now we bring in Chris Rankle in Pocatello. Chris is from Cleveland originally. Chris, this deal is for the maximum amount of money James could earn, but Cavs fans who haven't been able to even utter his name for the past 4 years are all of a sudden back in love with him. What's up?
Jeff, the best way I can explain this is before you go and criticize Cleveland sports fans, you got to understand what we've gone through. And I say we because I am a rabid Cleveland sports fan. Growing up in that area, we're well versed in heartbreak. The city hasn't won a championship since 1968. All of our failures, the decision, the drive, the fumble, Red Right 88, the list goes on and on. I could spend hours on this. But here's the thing that made LeBron leaving the first time so difficult is he was one of us. He grew up with that heartbreak. He saw the Cleveland Browns leave the city. And so when he left, it was like one of our own was turning our backs on him. But at the end, he says, this is all about home, and it is about home. That's why they're taking him back. We want him to bring that championship. We want to end the suffering. And he could. That's the thing. He really could. And I know my friend Matt Rogers called me this morning to make sure I was just getting out of bed, still sleepy-eyed, when I got that call. And I can tell you what, Jeff, I was critical. But I'm very happy he's coming back home.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Chris, for that take. Now to base.